We're all good.
Greetings, dear bootcampers. Welcome to lecture one of xPetu Technologies. This is how to invent your own off-meta builds. Let's get started. So, why should I invent my own builds? It's a fair question. Maybe you'll just say, okay, xPetu, you know, why should I go through the trouble of finding out itemization when I can just go to probuildstats.com or u.gg or probuildstats.com or YouTube, Kingsticks, xPetu, someone like this, find out the builds. I have a couple of factors that go into this. So I believe if you develop your own builds, you invent your own builds, you think about itemization, this will naturally also improve your understanding of itemization. You will start to understand, okay, this item is good in this scenario. When I'm behind, I could build this. When the enemies have lots of AP, I can build that, etc., etc. And the other thing is that simply theory crafting and optimizing these item builds, for me at least, it's a lot of fun. It's probably the most fun I have in League of Legends. I think about, this rune is kind of spicy. Maybe I could use it. Or this item is underutilized. Maybe I could put it into some kind of build. That always gives some kind of enjoyment for me. And then, at the end of the day, it feels fun to win versus opponents with your own off-meta build. You play that AP Nunu and one-shot the opponent. See what he thinks. You play, I don't know, full AD Soraka top lane with crit and one-shot the enemy AD carry with a fat Infinity Edge power spike. It feels kind of fun, you know, when it works, obviously. There's some downsides, the dark times when it doesn't work. But they're all just part of the learning process. So, the question is, how can I invent my own builds? Well, I have a three-step process for you guys. And it starts off with identifying. I will get into what this means, then exploring, and then optimizing. So what this identifying means, okay? First, we identify opportunities for off-meta builds. These opportunities can be, for example, high scaling ratios. So this could be something like a previously mentioned Nunu ultimate, which has a high AP ratio. Or maybe it's a Gnar ultimate, and Gnar is usually regarded as an AD champion, but for some reason his ultimate has a massive AP scaling ratio, so you might want to build him a certain way that emphasizes that ratio. Then we have other kind of huge ratios, for example, Shen's ultimate shield, big AP ratio. It feels fun to give a 2k shield to your teammates. The next opportunity is high base damages. So when is this relevant? For example, with champions that are typically built full damage, for example, Fizz, Echo, Assassins, stuff like this, they have in the past had so kind of powerful base damages or base numbers that building them in a tanky way that emphasizes durability over damage has proven to be successful, because those high base damages are enough to kill your opponents, and when you're tanky as an assassin with high mobility, it becomes a whole new beast, you know? So another thing then is high base stats. The kind of best example I can give you is when a champion has high base AD. So if you didn't know, Sheen gives you damage based on your base AD, and on champions with high base AD, Sheen is more valuable because it gives you more extra damage. So then that allows the opportunity for kind of funner builds. For example, one of my all-time favorites, Trinity Force Gragas, which in itself doesn't sound very good, but then you realize that Gragas has actually a very high base AD ratio, which makes Sheen a powerful item on him. High base AD, like flat. And this makes Sheen a good item on him. And then this Gragas build actually gives us the next point, which is flat cooldown reductions. So what do I mean by this? For example, in the past, Karma, with her passive and ultimate, would reduce the cooldown of her ultimate on every auto attack. So this would give rise to a off-meta build where you go lethal tempo and then you build something like Witch End and high attack speed in order to get lots of auto attacks in as karma and use that flat cooldown reduction on each auto attack to get your ultimate up fast, which would basically in turn make it possible for you to perma root someone with your mantra W. And the other one is Gragas with his E Body Slam, which has a 3-second flat cooldown reduction, I believe, if you hit a target with it. And there are other examples of this kind of scaling. But all I want you to think about here are kind of certain opportunities that could be utilized from an outside of the meta perspective in order to find kind of builds that are fun. And one of the things that you have to identify also is what champions do I enjoy playing. So you would most likely want to build or like create an off-meta build for a champion that you enjoy rather than a champion that you don't enjoy. The next step is explore. So which of these opportunities that we have previously identified intrigues me? What kind of makes me tick? When you think we had a couple of opportunities, oh yeah, karma top lane, but actually, you know, I don't want to be ranged top laner, so I'm not gonna play that. But full AP Nunu jungler sounds pretty fun, so I'm gonna try building that. That opportunity intrigues me. So then we will pursue that kind of natural direction of your thought process further. Next up, what we want to think about are item and rune synergies, not necessarily the synergies between items and runes, but between items and the champion, and runes and the champion, but then you can also go into the kind of intra-item rune synergies as well. Those are some kind of exploration topics. You want to come up with a first draft for the build. This is how I usually do it. So I just have a piece of paper, or I'm going on the whiteboard and I'm thinking like, maybe I'll just start off with Trinity Force first item on Gragas. Maybe second item, if I want to emphasize the kind of AD Bruiser Gragas playstyle, I'll go for something like Titanic Hydra. What boots should I fit in between there? Cooldown reduction. Just kind of make first four items, think about what builds could be possible for this champion, and make first draft of the runes as well. And then you just play a game with it. See how it feels. Most likely, it will be absolutely turbo bad, and you are gonna be like, why did I ever play this? But then you have those certain moments where it shines, and you're like, okay, there's something here, and we're gonna figure out what it is. And also wrote down that you should write down some notes, because I actually believe in the power of note taking. I usually just use the kind of sticky notes app on Windows, where I have like these notes on my desktop and then write some stuff down there. For example, when I discovered, I mean, I was not the first one to discover it, but when I learned about the Bramblevest game tank interaction, I wrote it down, and then I tested every single item in the game with game tank that could give it more stacks, and wrote down every single interaction, and then I started thinking about ideas how to utilize that in a build. And that's probably something that I will explore more in the future. And the third step is optimize. We want to make changes to the builds because some stuff just doesn't work. And then we think about the stuff that worked, what didn't. Play multiple games with the build, switch up some items, go this item first, then this item. And don't be afraid to deviate, because that's where a kind of the genius ideas come from. For example, this is kind of like inspirational for every gold elo player, or basically no matter what elo you are, even if you don't play ranked, did you know that blue Ezreal, which was a build that dominated the professional meta at some point, was actually originally discovered by a gold Ezreal main who just, I mean, at least the legend says it went like this. He just decided to build all items that were blue, and then discovered a build that was actually good and synergized well. So, I don't know, maybe if you explore the opportunities that come to your mind, you might just discover the next blue Ezreal build. And then I want to say iterate. This is an iterative process, and you want to constantly improve, constantly take feedback, and kind of funnel that, or channel that energy into making new changes, then evaluating those changes, reflecting on it, and making new changes. It's a constant process. And next up, I have a poll for you guys. because what we are going to be doing in this lecture is interactively developing a build ourselves. Okay, let's see. For you guys, I will copy paste it into the should I put it in the event chat? I'll put it in the event chat. And I want everyone to vote on their champion that they would like to see we making a build for them. Okay. Once we can conclude that Leona was indeed the most popular choice. And usually where I start is on League Wiki. That's my basic like starting point. Because I'll just have a look at the ratios and kind of the kit of the champion that I'm using as the champion that we're playing, basically. So we'll just have a look, for example, if we go to attack damage, there should be a list of kind of the base ADs. She's at 60, which is basically middle of the pack. So that makes her not that good of an Shen user, but it's still doable if you want to bring in a Shen item. Then we'll want to look at her abilities. So passive, I'm pretty sure passive is only triggered by allies, right? Damage dealt to marked enemies by allied champions, excluding Leona. So that obviously kind of inherently makes her a support, or it's kind of a pre-connotated restriction. But we don't need to care about that because we'll maybe do something. I'm thinking whether we go Leona jungle or Leona top, but probably Leona top lane because then we don't have to worry about clearing restrictions. So we'll focus on Leona top lane for now. And let's look at Q, for example. It has the mana cost. We don't care about that. Cooldown is flat 5. So what this usually tells me is that we don't want to be maxing this ability, which makes sense. I'm pretty sure Leona supports max W first, if I'm not mistaken. Some support man is going to flame me. But it only has a 30% AP ratio. This is not very exciting for us. Although this functions as an auto attack reset, so that works into the Shen idea a little bit. And it has a... What's the stun? It's always 1 second. That's good. So first of all, the ideas I'm getting from this is maybe Shen, maybe lots of ability haste to make some kind of perma stun build. But then look at Eclipse. Leona radiates solar eclipse around herself for 3 seconds, gaining bonus resistances and taking reduced damage. So reduced damage is always fun. And it also has flat damage reduction. So this is why maxing W could be very good. And then it detonates, dealing magic damage, and does it? It gives the resistances all over again if it hits an enemy. Well, makes sense. So you want to be in the fight. And here we have something that's not very common and not seen in that many champions. Is this scales percentually based on your resistances? So this naturally promotes a tank playstyle, but we do not have to accompany that idea necessarily. It also has a 40% AP ratio, but these AP ratios are not that big, because if there was another champion where it would have kind of normal tank playstyle, but then really high AP ratios, then it would be natural to go for something like full AP one-shot build, but we'll think about this. So in total right now we have 70% AP ratio, and we can see, look ahead to see that we have another 40%, so that's going to be 110% on a full combo without ultimate. And then there's also the magic damage, so this tells me that we're probably gonna max W without much knowledge of how to play Leona. And then E has a cooldown that goes down to 6 seconds, so that's also kind of juicy. Maybe we could max E first. The magic damage is pretty good, although W deals considerable damage as well, so we want to be thinking about what is kind of being, or what is the focus of our build. These two have basically the same damage. You could kind of summarize this as the same, because same ratio and similar base. That's base damages, I mean. And then Leona projects solar image. Okay, she shoots the blade forward and deals magic damage to all enemies hit, including minions. And if she hits at least one enemy champion, she's gonna dash. You know how it is, root for 0.5 seconds. All right. And then we have our ultimate, which has an 80% AP ratio. Now that's interesting. That's interesting. Now we have a total of 190% AP. So there are some opportunities for an AP Leona build, maybe. I'm thinking. Leona calls down beam of solar energy and grants a sight. Okay, we're gonna get sight of the area, and then the Leona ult is gonna come down, deal magic damage. It's gonna slow and stun the enemies.
All right.
So there are some kind of angles that we could take here. The Q angle is, this is good with Sheen in some sense. It's not very good with AP, although it has some AP. And it's good with ability haste. Overall, her kit benefits from ability haste heavily. And she has considerable damage if you build AP. So those are kind of the two directions that we could take. Now I'm gonna bring up LOL shop here. I sometimes use League Wiki because this can be outdated. This is 11.24. I feel like the in-game shop, like if you go to client, for example, here. Can you see the client? I believe you can. If you go to items here, like I really don't like this interface. I wish Riot would have something like better than this. So I'd rather use this browser version, which is third party, I believe. So we're firstly gonna think about mythics. This is kind of in season 11 and season 12, the way I normally build my ideas, because this is the most restricted item, since there's only a finite number or like low finite number of options. And we're just gonna exclude the ones that we don't like, okay? So I'm gonna take a screenshot of this and head on over to my trusty paint.net. And what we're gonna do is think about what items we don't want. So I'm gonna make a brush here with red on it. And we are not going for supportive. Even Shroud is really good on Leona, obviously, but since we're playing top lane, and this is basically the meta item for her, I'm gonna kind of exclude this due to the reason that they are meta and we want to make off meta builds. So I'm just gonna cross this out along with Locket because it's also meta. Imperial Mandate is kind of fun if we were playing support, then we could do like AP support Leona. But we're gonna exclude that since we're going to top lane. Then we have Moonstone, but we don't have heals. Exclude that. Even Shroud. Okay, that's kind of spicy. We're gonna keep that in for now. Everfrost. Okay. Everfrost offers us the possibility of completely kind of perma-stunning someone, because we can get a guaranteed... Ooh. Yeah, I like this. We're gonna keep this in, obviously. I don't really want to build tanks, since that's kind of boring here, since Leona is necessarily, or like normally seen as a tank, so I'm gonna exclude those. Now, y'all crazy if you want to go Dustblade, because we don't even do physical damage. Let's see, Eclipse. Omnivamp is less effective on AoE, and basically all of our damage is AoE, so it's not good. Prowler's Claw. that's a fun combo. I guess you could go Prowler's Q, but we are not interested in lethality right now, since we do magic damage mostly. Sunfire Aegis would be good if we went for a tank angle. So I'm actually gonna keep that in here because it's a viable mythic, but we're probably not gonna pursue it further. Rocket Belt is very good, because if we want to build some kind of assassin Leona playstyle, then Rocket Belt will naturally be good because it offers us burst and magic penetration. Riftmaker, that's also fun, but this suffers from the same consequence as Eclipse, because Omnivamp is not as effective when you have AoE. So, since most of my damage is AoE, we're not gonna benefit from it as much. I'm also gonna cross out these three, although the Gale Force Taunt, or the Gale Force E, I mean, Gale Force E stun could be a spicy combo. Trinity Force Divine Sunderer, I would probably... I mean, I would actually see that, like, Divine Sunderer... Wait. Wait, Leona is actually spicy champion. Because we can like take this approach of Everfrost. Divine is so overpowered with the hybrid penetration. Wait. My first thought process that was that we are gonna follow this. I'm gonna take the secondary color or something, like green for example, so we can highlight the ones. Oops, sorry. We're gonna highlight the ones that we are interested in. So Everfrost was interesting, but imagine Divine Sunderer Leona in the top lane. That's actually quite spicy. I like this idea. Let's see if we missed out on any. I really don't see why we'd go Ludens, because if we want pure damage, we would probably go Rocket Belt, because it gives us the mobility as well, and we don't have kind of constant ways of applying Ludens and poking, so I don't see this as being valuable. Even if we went for AD build, I would probably go for Divine Sunderer over these two, so we're gonna cross that out, yeet. And then... Okay, we're gonna put a pin in Everfrost. Now, let's have some silence, we need to think. So let's say we want to pursue... Let's kind of pursue both of these ideas, and then we decide once we have an idea on the full build. So we have Everfrost and Divine Sunder as our options. Then what would be the second item? Or maybe we'll start from the boots. So the boots... Like, naturally, I would tend towards plated steel cups or mercury threads. The reason being that steel cups can be very effective combined with, like, Leona's flat damage reduction and percentage bonus on armor and magic resist. But there's the option of going for lucidity boots, so you get even more ability haste. So maybe if we went for Everfrost, Anathemas, Perma-CC setup... You would go Lucidity. Yeah, there's some ideas there. I don't really see a reason why we would go Greaves or Mobi Boots unless support. And then Sorc Shoes, I guess if you're going for one-shot potential, you would go Sorc Shoes. So this would be something like Rocket Belt build. But right now, I think it's going to be Tank Boots or Lucidity Boots. Yeah, that's my idea. Then for the items, let's see some legendary items that could be spicy combined with either of those mythics. I actually, like, I'm just gonna do the same process, because this is legit, like, how I do it when I'm making build ideas. This is how I do it. I just take a mental image, or usually I bring it to my iPad so I can do this on the sofa or something. But I'm just gonna bring this in to paint. Now you're gonna say, use Epic Pen, do it in the browser. This is how I do it. So I'm gonna show you how to do it like I do it. So we're just gonna go through, okay, if you build May Eyes, you're an actual Chad. Because the fun thing is that, like, May Eyes on a tank can actually be good. So we're gonna say yes on that. Yeet. Yeet. And then Zeke's is good, but it's meta, so no. Rapid fire, no. This is good, but it's meta, so maybe yes. I'm gonna...
Does Staff of Flowing Water give AP to yourself if you're the target of a shield? Because then you could combine it with, like, Fimbulwinter.
Hold up. Is that some dark technology I'm sensing? Wait, we have to go to the League Wiki now. Staff of Flowing Water.
Yeah, no, it's another ally. It would have to go off of, like, Font of Life or something like that.
Nah, it doesn't work. Sorry. Yeah. Good idea, but doesn't work.
That's so unlucky.
But Fimbulwinter has been proposed multiple times. And I can see the reason why. Okay, I'm already getting ideas. I'm getting real ideas, guys.
Like, I'm thinking about a demonic embrace because of your massive AoE damage. Mm-hmm. So you can make use of that.
I mean, demonic embrace would also synergize with Fimbulwinter. Because...
What about Archangel Staff?
I'd rather you not interrupt me. Sorry. Because we need to be able to progress here. But it's okay to interrupt if I'm quiet. So, Fimbulwinter combined with Everfrost, because it gives you mana, and then that mana will be converted into health, and that health will be converted into AP by Demonic Embrace. Oh yeah, I'm sensing something. This might be dark technology. Demonic Embrace. So Everfrost gives big mana. Big mana goes big health. Big health goes big AP. That's three items already. And then... Oh! Then we go Ingenious Hunter. Oh, look. We go Ingenious Hunter. Oh, we go Ingenious Hunter to reduce the 8-second cooldown on Fimbulwinter, because we have basically CC all the time. So we can activate Fimbulwinter every time it comes off cooldown. So if we go Ingenious Hunter, it's also gonna function with Everfrost. Oh mama. This is a good one. We might have to pursue the Everfrost build. Yes. Yes. 30 second cooldown will be reduced by Ingenious Hunter. Okay. Idea. Everfrost, Fimbulwinter, Demonic Embrace. Boots. Is it gonna be ability haste boots?
Maybe Lich Bane?
Yeah, I mean, I guess Lich Bane, but does Lich Bane, when you think about it, does Lich Bane actually synergize with the build? It gives you more damage, right? That's the only thing that Lich Bane does. Okay, yeah, it gives you flat movement speed. Or not flat, but sorry, percentage movement speed. But Lich Bane doesn't, like, necessarily synergize that well with the build. And one thing that was already mentioned earlier was Anathema's Chains. Simply due to the fact that we have so much CC, that if we are side laning with... Okay. I like Anathema's Chains. What was it that you said?
Ryalize.
Yeah, Ryalize.
Pretty well.
But look, guys, do we need slows? We already have slow and E. We have root. How cost effective is this? 90 health, 90 AP, 350 health. Where is it? I don't really like Ryalize here. Also, League Wiki is really bad because it doesn't have any kind of input detection. So if you, for example, write Ryalize, because it doesn't have the hyphen in it, it's gonna exclude it from the search results, which is so dumb. But year is 2022. Maybe there's a better League Wiki in 5 years. So cost analysis. It's 96% gold efficient. I would probably rather build something with mana if we're just gonna go for raw stats. Yeah, go ahead.
What about a Frozen Heart?
Frozen Heart.
Because it's cheat, gives cooldown reduction, gives a lot of armor.
Yes, good. That was a good suggestion. I like Frozen Heart.
What about Horizon Focus?
And also about the Ryalize, it's not that useful because of your ultimate and you have very much slows on your kit itself.
Yeah, that's what I believe as well, because you already have enough CC to be constantly proccing Fimbulwinter, right? So you don't need like more slows, because your E has root, ultimate has slows last time, so I don't like Ryalize. But Frozen Heart is good because it gives us ability haste and mana. Go ahead.
How about Abyssal Mask if you're into heavy AP?
I was gonna say the same thing.
It also scales with your bonus HP. It reduces the enemy magic resist, I think. Abyssal Mask.
All right, next. Ooh.
Yeah, skills with HP.
Yeah, for sure. That could be. Look. This is good. This is good already. We have kind of divergent build paths now. So if we say core item build is Everfrost, Fimbulwinter, with Demonic Embrace, then depending on if you're facing lots of AD or lots of AP, you can either offer Abyssal Mask or Frozen Heart, right? Make sense?
What about Stone Blade?
did someone say Ghost Blade?
I said Cosmic Drive,
okay. I thought someone said Ghostblade. But Cosmic Drive? I don't really like it.
Titanic.
Titanic. I feel like...
What about Force of Nature?
It's a waste to go AD. Well, I mean, Force of Nature, it only offers you tankiness. And it's obviously a good item if you're facing multiple AP threats. But I would rather build something that synergizes with what we have just accomplished.
May I suggest Stoneplate, because it synergizes with the HP you get and the shield you get. You can utilize like maybe Shield Bash or some.
Yeah, I mean, I would say Stoneplate as your last item could be completely good, because it's kind of this expensive item that is extremely good in the late game in teamfights. So I would say Gargoyle Stoneplate is a fine item, but I think we have kind of a build already that we can use to build something else. I keep thinking about that Divine Sunderer, if we could have done that, but I feel like Fimbulwinter just requires that mana mythic. So
focus, because it procs on almost all your abilities and gives you extra damage.
But the thing is that it only gives me extra damage, right? So you're using 3,000 gold to only get extra damage, basically. The 150 health ability has not that much. It's an okay item, but I really doubt that that's what we're gonna need. I'm gonna write some stuff down now, or kind
if
of.
If you do Relize Crystal Scepter, it has health, AP, and it adds additional slow.
Yeah, but we don't need the slow, like we said earlier, so we're not gonna build Rylas, and then the stats aren't even that good on it. So
Shadow Flame as well. The same.
So, at this point, aren't we kind of getting to the point where it's like, you kind of start building normal items almost on Leona? Because you need to get tanky at this point. We're not tanky, are we?
Yeah, I mean, in some sense we are, because Fimbulwinter is giving us constant kind of shields, but I think at this point it's better to just go test it. The only thing that I'm wondering at this point is if we could have done something similar with Divine Sunderer.
What about Anathema's Chains?
Yeah, we that's on our list. Anathema's Chains is completely fine. The thing is with Anathema's Chains is it becomes almost meta. I mean, it's not a bad thing to build kind of meta items. It's obviously good because those items are naturally strong on the champion. But the idea is to just build something out of the box. And I think we have accomplished that in some sense. Do you guys want to... Are any of you in Europe West? We could play this in a custom game, for example. So I could play Leona in a custom game.
Yeah, I'm down.
Yes.
Can some of the moderators help me pick 9 people that write their summoner name somewhere so we could now? I'm still gonna take a moment to think about who picks Shen. I'm not picking Shen. I'm going Leona. But I'm thinking about the runes right now.
For sure, right?
I mean, not necessarily. It gives you some damage with Fimbulwinter, yeah. But we could also utilize something like Glacial Augment. So I'm gonna first look at the inspiration. No, not necessarily. Glacial Augment is the only one. Then we're gonna look at the Domination ones. This is just damage. I mean, Resolve is gonna be good, right? Because Grasp is just it's just good. So Grasp...
Phase Rush?
Spicy.
Can I say something real quick?
Yeah, go ahead.
So, I played once, full crit Leona, PTA, and it's actually a really good game.
Full crit Leona.
with like presence with like what is it called? PTA?
Press the attack.
Press the attack.
Yeah, yeah.
Because the auto attack cancel on her Q.
There's some ideas there.
The same for Fade Rush, right?
Press the attack and auto Q auto.
I really like Fade Rush actually. Because this allows us to go mana flow banned, which will be converted into health, which will be converted into AP. So
get Gathering Storm for more AP.
I actually like this. And then we could go... Transcendence is pretty good here. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Let's go Transcendence. And then... I mean... Honestly, like, Scorch is hard to make proper use out of on a melee champion. And Waterwalking is not that good on top lane. And Gathering Storm, I mean... okay, this is a hard one, because Waterwalking has some utility. Maybe we'll go Scorch and try to kill them early on.
You're becoming River Leona.
Can we just take it secondary? And we still get the mana flow bland?
Sure, but I actually really like Phasers, because this works similar to Gragas top lane, where having kind of movement speed on a tank can be actually really useful, because in team fights it's easy to get kind of kited out by carries. So I actually like this Bowser, idea.
Bowser's Scion, he does phase rush.
Yeah. And then I would go for cheap shot with Ingenious Hunter.
Not sudden impact?
No, no. A cheap shot is always going to be more damage than sudden impact. I'm pretty sure. Even though Sudden Impact works on our E, Cheap Shot will be much easier to proc, and the true damage will most likely be more damage than the Sudden Impact.
Yeah,
also we don't care about lethality.
And I'm thinking attack speed will be useful, because it's actually good on champions to improve their last hitting. And then this will be decided based on matchup. Okay.
Or go HP for the more AP in the late game from the Demonic Embrace.
And that also works. That also works. We're actually gonna do that. Yeah, okay, we have Newton runes ready.
Could you potentially, once you're comfortable with last hitting as Leona, get rid of the attack speed and go Adaptive Force? Or CDR, sorry, CDR.
I mean, Ability Haste. Sure. But it's actually crazy how efficient that attack speed rune can sometimes be, because it can it can be like kind of the difference between getting a kill and not when you have that one attack speed. But then you can also make the same argument for ability haste, because you can get the last E in there. So that's
thank you for making my argument for me.
Yeah. Okay, we're gonna start the game. Pretty sure this was blind pick. Let's see what summoner spells I'm gonna go.
I can see a possible
result. TP Ignite Giga Chad.
Flash Ghost. No, I'm probably gonna go Ignite. I'm moving down my electric chair. I mean electric desk. Ooh, okay. Now where's it?
How much they paying you, huh? Electric desk.
Phase rush, mana flow. Actually, someone made a good argument that mana flow only gives us 20 HP, so is it like really worth take it for that synergy? Probably not. But let us try. We'll see how it goes.
It's not bad in the early game, because recall correctly, you have pretty high mana cost.
Are we concerned about damage in this build?
What's that?
I said, why not boosting still flash, but when I said something else.
I didn't understand your question, sorry.
I said, why not ghost instead of flash?
Because... I mean, flash is the best summoner spell in the game.
Nice skin.
Thank you.
was gonna say something about you better have a skin. Very disappointed.
All right, let's see the matchup.
It's gonna be a Leona counterpick.
Leona mirror matchup.
Yeah, it's a Leona mirror matchup.
I wonder if you could hear my audio, by the way, because I'm not sure if Discord screen share always gives you audio if you don't select league.
You would have to select league if you want to. Okay. So you could restart it and do a league screen share, and then we could restart the daisy chain.
Yeah.
I think that what will happen, though, is that for the daisy chainers like myself, we'll end up streaming his voice as well. So it'll be like the first stream will be able to unmute, but the rest of us can't.
We can try it out. If worst comes to worst, there'll be no game sound.
Users can just mute the daisy stream. I don't know. But then, yeah, it's...
Okay, I started streaming leagues. Now audio should be fine.
Is it a good idea to, like, look at other players' builds for your own builds, or...?
Yeah, because you can derive inspiration from them, and usually if you're looking at someone like Challenger One Trick Ponies, then they will have a good understanding of what's good on that champion. So for sure it's productive to look at other people's builds, but the kind of main point that I want to bring across is the fact that it is also beneficial to think about them yourself. I have a bad feeling that this Shen player is gonna giga stomp me. Welcome back, viewers. After our failed attempt, or not failed, you know, it's a part of the process, the innovation process continues. After our attempt at Everfrost Leona top lane, I decided to switch it up and go for Divine Sunderer this game. So should be interesting how this one works out. I'll put the voice volume at 50. Yeah. So now the build idea. Go Divine Sunderer first item. Based on the opponent's team comp, I'm planning to go Mercury Strats. It seems to be the boot option here. And then I had in mind like whether we want to try Winter's Approach again. It doesn't have the mana synergy as it did with Everfrost, so you're losing some value there. And I don't think Leona will have mana problems. So I want to try this game without going for the tier build. And maybe go straight into a Demonic Embrace after our Sunderer. So that will be the test 2 item. And then we will kind of adapt probably maybe with something like a Frozen Heart. That could be possible. Because the Zed and Jin will start doing damage. But before that we're fine with just the magic resist. And we're playing with Silas in the top lane, and this is a flex queue game on my Master Tier account. So I don't know about the skill level of the players, but they should be platinum to diamond level. Boom, Leona combo. Oh no, I should have queued immediately. I thought I could get in one extra auto attack. Big Leona, I mean big Lee Sin. Okay, we win this. Oh no, he got mana back. I need to get these. Can't really do much there. Okay, Lizzie, you're out of there. Nice. Is Lee Sin is playing well. I'm coming. Yeah. This is the moment where we win the game. Got him, coach. Oh, sorry, I got it. I'm coming, Lee Sin. Now Silas is gonna kite us out. Slows, something. Uh-oh. Why did I start maxing Q again? Good slow. But he can! He can ult in my E. Because I definitely eat him there. Or that boys! This is the big one. This is huge. Yes! We got it, team. I believe. We are scaling! And I'm going back in! Bonk. Silas? Chia! Uh-oh. Leona face tanking in the entire team. Big, huge. I'm tanking damage. We got one. And it secures us the Drake. Look at that. Played tank like a pro. Absorb as much damage as possible. Okay, at least I got a slow or something. Let's go! Flash was maybe wasted. Jin, get over here. Look at this sidestep. DJ Swag Pants. Got the slow, it's worth. Lee Sin. Big, Swain. No. Got time to reposition. Boom. Enemy in here spawning soon. Uh-oh, I can't move. If it's the last thing I do, I will kill the Samumu. Yes. Might be the last thing I do. No. Jin, you're going down. Enemy in hip spawn. Jean, come over here. Ah! No, chill. Okay, he didn't auto-attack me. Eep! E- Yo, yo, he just got a quadra kill. Oh. Huge! The boys are doing work. The Sunderer Leona. Got him, chief. I'm almost dead. Oh no, oh no. Look, we prepared the backdoor with that. I'm still alive. Never mind. But the boys? 1 second. Go, go, go. Kill it, kill it, kill it, kill it. We won. We won, Zulul. Obviously, this is the most broken top lane build you've ever witnessed. Okay, guys.